Welcome to Meddy Simplified. Today we'll discuss a topic from middle ear, a disease of middle ear called as Acute Suppurative Otitis Media, also abbreviated as ASOM. So what is Acute Suppurative Otitis Media? It is an acute inflammation of otitis media, means middle ear, caused by any pyogenic infections. This disease is most commonly seen in children, infants, and people of low socioeconomic group. So, it is most commonly seen in infants, children, and people of low socioeconomic group. So why it is seen most commonly in infants and children, we'll discuss it as we continue our topic. The causative agents, any pyogenic infection as we discussed. So the pyogenic infection are caused by some causative agents, which are, so let's discuss the causative agents. The causative agents for ASOM. We have some bacteria, we have some viruses which are responsible for acute suppurative otitis media. So those are first Streptococcus pneumoniae. It is most common cause of ASOM in children. Then second we have Haemophilus influenzae. It is second common cause of ASOM. Third we have Moraxella catarrhalis. Other causative agents, other bacteria which are also responsible for ASOM are, fourth we have Streptococcus pyogenes. We have sometimes Staph aureus and also Pseudomonas aeruginosa. Staph aureus is most common cause of, we have already discussed, localized otitis externa, whereas Pseudomonas aeruginosa is most common cause of malignant otitis externa. So these are the causative agents. Also we have some viruses which are responsible. I'll try to mention them here. Viruses, viral infections which are responsible for ASOM. First, Second, influenza virus. And rhino and adenovirus. So these are the causative agents for ASOM. Now we'll discuss Streptococcus pneumoniae is the most common cause, and Haemophilus influenzae is second most common cause. Now we'll try to discuss the roots of infection. How does the ASOM spread, or how does any infection reaches the middle ear? So we'll discuss the roots of infection. Root of infection. in this, we have three reasons, three routes. The first is eustachian tube via eustachian tube. The second is via external ear. And the third is bloodborne. The bloodborne type, the route is very rarely seen, it is least common. And one out of thousands cases is due to bloodborne route. Eustachian tube. We have already discussed that ASOM is most commonly seen in infants and children. Why? Because it spreads through eustachian tube, and the eustachian tube of children are shorter, wider, and horizontal, more horizontal in infants, and eustachian tubes is more shorter, wider, and horizontal in infants and children. So the possibility or the accessibility for the viruses or bacteria to pass to the middle ear through eustachian tube is more easier in infants and children, and that is why ASOM is most commonly seen in children and infants. The other reason, that is the other route, that is why external ear, is due to any perforation in tympanic membrane. Suppose this is the ear, this is the external auditory canal, here we have tympanic membrane, and then we have middle ear. Okay, so any perforation, small perforation in the tympanic membrane will help the bacteria or viruses who are responsible for this infection, will help them to pass through those perforation, and it will reach to the middle ear and may cause the infection. So this is the introduction, the definition, what is acute suppurative otitis media. It is acute inflammation of middle ear caused by any pyogenic infections. The causative agents, it is seen most commonly in infants and children. The reason is, when the infection is spreading via eustachian tube, the eustachian tube is more shorter, wider, and horizontal in infants when compared with adults. The causative agents, Streptococcus pneumonia, it is most common cause in children. Second, Haemophilus influenza. We have Staph aureus, Pseudomonas aeruginosa, many other viruses. This all are the responsible causative agent for ASOM and the route of infection. So now, we'll try to... This disease is been divided into some stages. So we'll try to study about each stage. There are usually four stages of ASOM. So we'll start, we'll mention them in order first, then we'll discuss about each of them one by one. So the first is stage of tubal occlusion. Then the second is stage of pre-suppuration. Then the third stage is stage of suppuration, and the last is stage of resolution. So these are the four stages. Now we'll discuss each of them one by one. The first is that is stage of tubal occlusion. What happens is when we have the entry of bacteria or any infectious pyogenic organism, which is called an infection in the middle ear, it leads to occlusion of tube, Eustachian tube. So Eustachian tube is occluded. What else will happen? The tympanic membrane is retracted. In stage 1, that is the stage of tubal occlusion, the Eustachian tube is occluded, that is, it is blocked, and the tympanic membrane is retracted. There are many different symptoms seen in each stages. The most common symptom is deafness. Deafness is seen, that is, of conductive type of hearing loss is seen in all stages. So what we'll see in stage of tubal occlusion, we'll see mild earache, which is very negligible, no fever, and slight hearing loss. After that comes the stage of pre-suppuration. The occlusion for a very long time, the tympanic membrane, it gets congested. The tympanic membrane gets congested or contracted, congested. So what happens? Inflammatory exudates are seen. Inflammatory exudates are seen in this stage. After that, what happens? The tympanic membrane bulges. We'll see a bulging tympanic membrane, bulging and red tympanic membrane, which has lost the hallmark signs or hallmark locations. The tympanic membrane will be bulging and red, and it will lost its hallmark locations. Or we can say it will lose its landmarks. This specific condition is called as cartwheel appearance. That is, the tympanic membrane will be red, bulged, and it will lose its landmark. That is, whatever points or whatever landmarks we see in the tympanic membrane will be lost. We will not be able to localize them. Then comes the stage of suppuration. What happens here? The tympanic membrane is about to rupture. Why? Because of pus formation in middle ear. There will be formation of pus in the middle ear, and the tympanic membrane will be about to rupture. So what we will see, the pus will come out in a pulsatile manner, in a pulsatile manner. In a pulsatile manner with synchronized, which will be synchronized, which will be synchronized, synchronized with the arterial pulse. The pulse will start, the tympanic membrane is not ruptured yet, but the pulse will start coming out very slowly in a synchronized manner along with the arterial pulse. So this is called as lighthouse sign or pulsatile otorrhea. The symptoms which will be seen in pre-suppuration stages is earache, which will be very, very, very painful, and the patient will not be able to sleep during night times, and he will have mild fever. Earache, mild fever, increased hearing loss. This will be the sign seen in the pre-suppuration, and we'll see cartwheel appearance in pre-suppurative stage. Then in the stage of suppuration, the tympanic membrane will be about to rupture. It will be about to rupture due to the pus formation in the middle ear, and the pus will come out in pulsatile manner with which will be synchronized with arterial pulse due to increased pressure in middle ear. The way how the pus is coming out from the middle ear is called as pulsatile otorrhea or lighthouse sign. Then comes the last stage called as stage of resolution. After all this, at last what happens, the tympanic membrane ruptures with the release of pus. The tympanic membrane ruptures with release of pus. And along with it, the symptoms are relieved. One more thing happens in this stage of suppuration. A nipple-like projection is seen in tympanic membrane with a yellow spot on it. So these are the four stages: stage of tubal occlusion, stage of pre-suppuration, stage of suppuration, and stage of resolution. What happens in first stage? The tympanic membrane is retracted due to occlusion of eustachian tube. Then the next stage, what happens? It gets more congested. The tympanic membrane gets more congested, and we can see inflammatory exudates, and we see the tympanic membrane loses its all the landmarks, and it becomes bulging and red. This is called as cartwheel appearance. Then we have in this stage we will see earache, mild fever, and increased hearing loss. Then we have the third stage, that is the stage of suppuration. In this stage, what happens? Pus is formed in the middle ear. Then it comes out very slowly along with the arterial pulse due to increased pressure in the middle ear. This is called as lighthouse sign or pulsatile otorrhea. Then in this stage of suppuration, the tympanic membrane has a nipple-like projection on it with a yellow spot. Then the last stage comes, that is the stage of resolution. In the stage of resolution, what happens that the tympanic membrane ruptures and releases all the pus along with the release of pus, what we see, we'll see the symptoms are relieved. Now, there is one more stage. We can call it as a stage, or it is called a stage of complications. What happens there, in some cases, due to some reasons which I'll discuss now, the tympanic membrane, the disease is not resolved, the symptoms are not relieved. This is the last stage. Some people include it in the stage of otitis media, some not. So we'll just write it as stage of complication. Stage of complications. What happens due to high virulence, of organism? And sometimes low persistence of patient due to high virulence of organism and low persistence of patient, the resolution does not take place due to high virulence of organism and low persistence of patient, the resolution does not take place. And the infection spreads beyond the middle ear. And it causes other disease, which we call as complication of ASOM. So we'll just list out those disease. First we'll see most commonly acute mastoiditis. What is happening in, due to high virulence of organism and low persistence of patient, the resolution does not take place and the infection spreads beyond the middle ear and causes other disease. So we'll see acute mastoiditis. We can see facial paralysis. You may see laryngitis. You may see petrositis. And many other diseases, many abscesses like brain abscess, subperiosteal abscess. So many complications, some of them are this. Out of this, the acute mastoiditis is the most common complication of otitis, any acute otitis media in children. Facial paralysis is very least commonly seen, especially in ASOM, it is very least commonly seen. The subperiosteal abscess, it is the most common extracranial complication. Complication of ASOM. So this was the stage of complications. Now we will discuss about the treatment. We discussed about the causative agent. We discussed about the disease. What is the disease about? We discussed about the stages. Now we will discuss We discussed about the complications. Now we'll discuss the final part of our video, that is the treatment. By now, I think everyone is clear that any disease or any otitis of external or middle ear, we will go with ear toilet. First of all, we'll clean the ear, all the pus, all the bacterial remains which are there in the ear canal, we'll just try to remove it by ear toilet. We'll go with, in this acute, in case of ASOM, we go with antibacterial and antibiotics therapy. What we give usually, we usually give amoxicillin or ampicillin. These both are drug of choice in case of ASM. But in some patient we may give penicillin. Depends. Penicillin. If they are resistant to penicillin, they are resistant to amoxicillin or ampicillin, we may go with cefaclor, which is a second generation cephalosporin. Second generation cephalosporin. We may go with erythromycin. We may give them erythromycin and sometime cotrimoxazole. So we'll give antibiotics. In antibiotics, we'll go with amoxicillin, ampicillin, which is the drug of choice. We may go with penicillin. If they are resistant to this drug, we may go with second generation cephalosporin, or we may go with erythromycin or cotrimoxazole. Then we give nasal decongestants. We may give nasal decongestants. Why we need nasal decongestants? We need nasal decongestants because we need to decrease the edema of tympanic membrane. Then we may do ear toilet, we may give antibiotics therapy, we may go with nasal decongestant for to decrease the edema. Also we can give analgesics and antipyretics, because our patient may have earache, he will have sometimes mild or high grade fever. So most commonly we go with paracetamol in case of ASM. This were the medical therapy. We may go with meningotomy. It is a kind of surgical process. We'll go with meningotomy. So what is meningotomy? We'll try to evacuate the pus. We'll try to evacuate the pus from the eardrum by doing an incision in it. So meningotomy. What is meningotomy? Incising the eardrum. To evacuate the pus. So what are the indications in case of ASOM for meningotomy? Indications for meningotomy. Suppose we are giving our patient antibiotics for a prolonged time, but he is not recovering. Suppose our patient is having bulged drum and acute pain, and he is not able to stay stable. Suppose he is having a kind of facial paralysis along with ASOM, or we may see persistent effusion. So we will go with meningotomy. So when will we do meningotomy? If our patient is having bulged eardrum along with pain. Severe pain. no resolution. If our patient is having no resolution, no decreased symptoms, even after use of antibiotics, no resolution even after antibiotics. Or suppose the patient is having ASOM along with facial paralysis. One more case, that is, suppose excess of pus is coming out from tympanic membrane for more than 12 weeks. We'll go with myrmidon. So, these are the treatment. We'll go with ear toilet, antibiotics therapy. We may give nasal decongestants like ephedrine. Why we are giving it? Just to decrease the edema of tympanic membrane. For decreasing the pain and fever, we may give paracetamol. If all this therapy, all this treatment is not working, we will go with myrmidon. So we discussed everything about acute suppurative otitis media. Thanks for watching the video. Please like and subscribe my channel, Meddy Simplified. Thank you.